This is not DJ PEVU. This is Parliament. Now he has become DJ PESA. He has left being DJ PEVU, now he's DJ PESA. He's looking for money, music everywhere like this, like a rat. Mr. Speaker, with those few remarks, that man must be named.
My last contribution, when you made a ruling about political parties, Mr. Speaker, I said on record here that there are no proper independent members in this house. When I was talking about that matter, I was talking specifically about the same member. Because he came to this house as an independent member, but he has turned out to be more dangerous than even members who are in serious political parties. Mr. Speaker, this member, in the last general election, came to seek our party ticket in the direct of election. And we denied him, Mr. Speaker, because we knew this man can only do best in the street, not in the house, Mr. Speaker. And now we have been vindicated. From the way he's behaving now in town, my party has been vindicated for denying him the ticket, Mr. Speaker. Because we have given our ticket to the wrong person, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, the standing orders are very clear that for you to impeach a state officer under 64C, you must produce evidence, Mr. Speaker. You must attach the evidence that you want to use against the state officer, Mr. Speaker. This is a member who has just collected documents from all over Riverside, River Road. He could not produce them in Parliament. Now he's trying to malign the names of Kenyans outside there, Mr. Speaker, and Parliament, saying that the Speaker has denied him the opportunity to impeach the CS in this House, Mr. Speaker. This is not the first time a member has filed a motion against a minister, Mr. Speaker. We discussed here, for those of us who are members of the last Parliament, we discussed Professor Kemeny here a whole afternoon, Mr. Speaker, and you are the one who approved it. We even discussed you, Mr. Speaker. You remember somebody brought a motion against you. We discussed you a whole afternoon here, Mr. Speaker. That is how transparent this Parliament is, Mr. Speaker. And we have a member here who is a former journalist. You know, the rules of journalism and the rules of Parliament are totally different, Mr. Speaker. You can't apply the rules of journalism here. Journalism, you look for information by all means you can. But here, you use the rules, the standing orders, procedure, and traditions to execute what your mandate here, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, this member qualifies to be taken back to the induction court. Because it doesn't look like somebody who has understood how Parliament operates. From what I saw him yesterday, he was even accusing me why I was whipping members not to append their signatures in his fake signature collection list. He was standing in front of the gate here, telling people that this is a circle for Lord. He was not even telling them that this is an impeachment motion, Mr. Speaker. That is how untruthful he was, Mr. Speaker. I have around six members of my party who told me I signed that petition. I thought it was about Bunge Circle. I never knew it was an impeachment of a minister. Because there were no grounds to impeach a minister that he was telling them. No, honestly, Mr. Speaker, members are here, they can speak for themselves. Mr. Speaker, we cannot allow a member to impeach with proper motives in this house. This is a house of dignity. This is a house that is respected. If he feels that he cannot survive in this house under the rules, Mr. Speaker, he has no option but to get out. Lastly, Mr. Speaker, if you look at the other day, I don't know how to share this with the member. I went and visited the Speaker in his office. So he brings some documents here. Some of them were court of appeal judgments. Now, judgments that have been made, what has Parliament got to do with it? So you go appeal to the Supreme Court. Mr. Speaker, I want to tell you that your ruling was timely. Your ruling defended the Constitution and the statutes and the standing order, and we have no apologies to make.